Very good morning to students. Today I am going to explain various type of drilling and matrix classifications of the drill holes with various techniques and relationships particularly open cast mining. My name is Karuna Kumar, HOD Mining, Government Polytechnic, Department of Education. Now, the prime objective of this lecture is the classification of the basis on depth or basis on the diameter classifications of the drilling holes in the open cast and various type of patterns also going to explain in around 45 slides of the 50 minutes lecture. After completion of this topic, you can able to understanding classifies the holes based on depth, diameter, and pattern. The surface mining requires drilling for a different purpose. The one is a production drilling, is an exploration drilling, and the technical drilling also you can say. But production drilling is a major part of our lecture is concerned. Exploration drilling is another part for the collection of the samples or something. These are three categories of general surface drills, different purposes. Now, coming to production drilling, for making holes for placement of explosives for blasting. The object of drilling and blasting is to prepare well fragmented loose rock amenable to excavation with better productivity for the excavation machinery. The holes drilled for this purpose are defined as a blast hole. The other hand is the exploration drilling is actually this is Geological Survey of India major core recovery purpose the exploration drilling. Drilling for the sampling collection to be estimated to quality and quantity of the resource. The samples are collected as a core and the drilling for such purpose are referred as a core drilling. As the diamond bits are used for such a drilling, core drilling is often called as a diamond drilling. Most of the exploration drillings are the diamond drilling pattern. Analysis of the when you are visited in the first year collect the geology map, exploration of the character of the drill, the structure of the rock related to the exploration. A third part is the technical drilling during development of mine for the drainage slope stability and foundation of testing purpose. These are the generally technical purposes that say they are using the drilling. Then secondary blasting also using small scales, small purpose. The major classifications are the only production drilling is our prime objective, making the holes for the preparing for the blast, for boring of the explosives. The production drilling is a major role for the fragmentation of rock bodies. Blast hole drill is a technique used for the mining whereby a hole is drilled to the surface of the rock packed with explosive material and detonated. The aim of this technique is to induce cracks in the inner geology of the surrounding rock in order to facilitate further drilling and associated with mining activity. The initiation hole into which the explosives are packed is known as the blast hole. The blast hole drill is one of the primary surface drilling employed in the mining operation. So, the aim of technique reduce cracks among inner geology surrounding the activity is a blast hole drill. But actually, the explosive packing known as the blast hole is completely the purpose of the blast hole. Popularly known as a blast hole. A drilling is a process of making a hole to a hard surface, whereas the length of the hole is very large compared to the diameter. In the context of mining engineering, drilling refers to making holes into a rock mass. So the drilling is a process of making hole. This is a major activity where the length of the hole is very large compared to the diameter. In the context of mining engineering, drilling refers to making holes. Crack rock masses, most of the rock masses are used. The gunpowder is now used to have been used for a military purpose of in those olden days. Now rock blast in mines in 17th century onwards. The complete change scenario in 19th century frame is kind of prepared nitroglycerin engine based. Nobel scientist Alfred Nobel used the first commercial high explosive dynamites started. From that one, the scenario of the complete deconcentrated fragmentation is completely changed. The action of explosive is a primary through an extremely rapid exothermic chemical reaction. So what is happening in the explosive? Basically, the sudden release of energy, the basic concept, produces a large volume of gases at a high temperature and exerts a sudden high pressure on the conforming rock mass, those breaking it. The different techniques of blasting patterns of drilling or belt detail in this image. Different techniques of blasting patterns of drilling are detailed in this classification. Basing on diameter, so most of the blast holes are using for the purpose of the blasting purpose, explosive joints, inserting one. But what are the types of holes you are using? That you also want to basing on the diameter. You have a small diameter to big diameter, depending upon the mission usages or depending upon the pattern usages. So now, small diameter holes are up to 50 mm is called small diameter hole, because it's concerned. Generally employed for the secondary drilling and general drilling is jackhammer. Very low, 30 mm to 50 mm is underground holes almost. These are meant for the purpose of the secondary hole. For the small cartridges can be used as a explosive charges. And medium holes are up to 100 meters. These are also are generally employed for the primary drilling. In mines with load bench height up to 7 meters and for drilling in a butter. Large diameter holes above 100 to 200 mm. The holes are employed for the primary drilling in a large mechanized open cast mines with bench height over 7 meters. Classification basing on depth. Shallow depth holes, these holes are used for secondary drilling. The depth range from the 1.2 to 1.5 meters. Medium depth holes, these holes are used for the primary and secondary drilling. The hole depth range from the 3 to 5 meters. Long hole drills, these holes are used for the primary blasting only. The hole depth range from the 100 to 30 meters, 10 to 30 meters. Classification basing on pattern of drill holes. Single row blast pattern, multi row blast pattern, traverse cut pattern, wedge blast pattern, diagonal blasting patterns. These are different patterns, classification based on pattern of drill holes, the classification of pattern, the single row blast pattern and multi row blast pattern, traverse cut pattern, wedge blast pattern, diagonal blast pattern. These are the patterns you are most of the mines are using. Methods to determine the blast hole diameter, but some increasing this able to see. Now it is a good pattern. So methods to be determined blast hole diameter, but the button for the button spacing, stemming, hole depth, and powder factors are present in this chapter. These methods have been developed based on the field studies carried out by the other design parameters such as the bench height, hole inclination and subgrades. The influence initiation sequence and delay timing on the blast performance were investigated using the sequential blasting machine based on the results and analysis of several case studies. A typical diagram illustrated in the problem is solution related to the initiation sequence and delay turning also presented in the coming delay element is concerned. The bench height is decided by the mine planner depending upon the local geology, production rate and the type of the loading equipment. The mining regulations also influencing the design of bench. You already heard about that one. And slope, stability considerations for a blasting engineer. The bench heights usually a fixed parameter sometimes. The bench height may vary due to the topographical changes and nature of the formations. So this is also one of the influence factors for the other side of the blasting phenomenon. The selection of the holes. The selection of holes. The selection of hole diameter is governed by several factors such as a bench height, critical diameter of the change, arch, drilling cost, production requirement, rock structure, the acquired degree of fragmentation, environmental constraints, and unit cost of the production. Some of these factors require large diameter holes. As it is necessary to take a balance by selecting an optimum hole diameter. For the detonation theory of explosion, hole diameter should be greater than the critical diameter of the charge. But this is not a problem of surface mines because of hole diameters are larger than the critical diameter of the charges. So these are the other side of the factors of the diameter of the hole if increases. So automatically bench height should be more, cost of drilling, production requirements, fragmentation size, environmental concerns also you have to take into consideration. So selection of optimum hole diameter from the diameter theory of explosives. So you have to exercise the problems that one. Now pattern of drilling. What are the patterns of drilling? We'll go through here. Pattern of drilling is a technique that is used when a sequence of holes must be drilled within the very tight location or tolerance or array of an involving a variety of sizes, depths and dimensional orientations. Empirical formulas are developed by the different modifications. Following symbols are defined from some of the relations are very important. The standardized formula for preparation purpose. So generally the D is meant for the diameter of the hole. Most of the nowadays you are using not inches, most of the your areas in your diameter is in mm. The room later on will convert into that meters later on. The button also in most of them is the meters. Presently you are using most of the meters. And from charge of the nearest free face to the direction of the displacement of the most like occur. So button is the part of the free face. Spacing also in terms of the meters, not in feet. Meters between the two holes, we should perpendicular to the corresponding button. Capital L is the whole length of the depth. It's also in meters. It's also in a meters. Everything for SI units you are using. Subgrade drill, which is very long, after the bed height, more than that one, they preparing, they're not forming any toy formations. And the stemming is also there. This is also stemming for the purpose of column. 3/4 column is explosive. Remain is the for the stemming we can be used. Filling of the, that also important. Top portion of the hole containing intermaterial needed of preventing premature ejection of the gases. Another is a bench height. This is also in meter. Meters. So these are the overall parameters you are using in the pattern is concerned. So now I once again I repeating, D is the diameter in mm, capital B is the button, the distance in meters from a charge to the nearest to free phase in the direction, the displacement will most like to occur. S equal to space, the distance in meters between the two holes, measure perpendicular to the corresponding button. Capital L, hole length or depth in meters. J, sub drill length in meters, the depth that hole extends below the anticipated grade or floor. The stemming height or collar distance in meters. The top portion of the holes containing the inert material intended to prevent premature ejection of the gases. Capital H, bench or face height in meters. Capital H is equal to bench or face height. So these are the parameters, pattern parameters can be, most of standardized formulas can be utilized. Now, some relation is there. In this relationship, the burden and spacing dimensions are the short burden and spacing, which may or may not be the drilled button and spacing. Changes in the initiation timing scheme will be determined the difference. Moreover, it is important to understand that the blast parameters listed are interrelated and the change one parameter will have in the impact of the others. So one simple same, what are the nomenclature you are learned that will be showing in this figure. So that it is a, here you can easily understand what is the D, what is the button and spacing, what is the relationship also. So here clearly H is equal to bench height, that is the capital H is a bench height, is showing you from the here to here. B is a button, the from free phase to the first row of the hole and signal is a button. Spacing is yes, the distance between two holes. So L is the overall length of the hole, but you detect the J. J is the length of the sub drill. So D is the stemming. Stemming can be showing here. Stemming material is top, this portion is stemmed. So hole diameter, so D is the hole diameter. So these parameters are very essential for calculation of the volume, power quadrant calculation, the purpose you are using. Then, so these are the each hole already early figure you are understand, but these are the patterns. Most of the patterns are using. Here you can observe them. This is the free phase. We're giving number one, and this is the three, this is the two, and again one and two. So two is come like this, and three is come this fourth line. So this is called box cut expanding V type cut. Box step extended V type cut. And another here, so this is one, this is two, this is two, this is two, one, one, one. The three, the three. So this box cut expanding flat bottomed drill pattern. The pattern holes the numbering equal number will be blast initially. later on remain. Similarly, corner cut helicon type. This is a corner cut. The complete the power the direction. This direction the meter will be falling. So you can observe here 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3. This is a numbering from delay. Similarly, corner cut helicon type pattern. This is another pattern. This is another corner cut pattern. 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, and 4, 4, 5, 5, and 6. So button B for button. S for a short, two for a space. Sometimes you use a drill button and space is also using. But most of patterns are usage in such a manner. So here the basic functions of blast results. Which is our controllable, which are not our controllable, not uncontrollable. Thus, they can be easily understood here. Non-controllable variables, what are the non-controllable, which is not in our hands? So only controllable variable we can control or increasing or decreasing or taking to economical way. So non-controllable variables. Or geology is a non-controllable variable. So most rock mass characteristics is coming to that jointing, presence of water. These are the naturally situations in the mine. Now, what are the controllable variables? Drilling, charging, and firing. These three are we can be within our hand. So similarly, hole diameter within our hand, hole depth within our hand, sub drill within our hand, inclination within our hand, bench height within our hand, hole deviation. So means inclination, hole deviation means you can sometimes vertically you can maintain, sometimes inclined maintain. Bench height depending upon our inclination you can maintain, sub drill you can maintain, hole depth you know. Hole diameter known. So total drilling activities within our hands. What are the controllable variables for charging? Here, type of explosives. Type of explosive depending upon the rock nature, go to N4 or ESG based. The type of explosive can be charging can be used, explosive energy, charging method, charge design, charge length, delay patterns. These are the major things. Another firing. Firing the detonator system, delay time, proper cleaned phase, number of free phases, and water. These are the firing natures. You go to there. Whether you go to detonating system by firing or delay time you are applying or proper cleaned phase you are going to use. Free phase or number of free phases. Depending upon free phases also firing is going on. So through watery nature, the application of overheating is different. So now these are the major activities or firing procedures. So overall controllable variables within our hands. Then blasting activities is done. Then after blasting, what are the results? The fragmentation is done. Post-blasting rock file profile and thrones, fire rack problems, blast-induced ground vibrations, back and side break, under break, non-detonating holes or misfires, complete misfires. So these are the complete evaluation of blasting patterns concern. Now, blast hole inclination. benefits of inclined drilling in a surface, benefits of inclined drilling in surface. Benefits, what are the benefits of the inclined drilling in surface? So, sometimes blasting inclined is a benefit, sometimes vertical is also benefiting. Let us see, in bench blasting, inclined drilling is extend numerous benefits. These are the better fragmentation, better displacement, and swell of the buckmail, and burden is kept in almost in constant uniform along with the test blast hole, and angular projection of blast increases. So I can see the better explanation is very clear in this figure. You can able to understand what are the advantages of inclined and straight, inclined and vertical. Vertical means the here burden is less, but burden going inside is more due to the our maintenance of the material slope stability is concerned. A similar inclination is the burden is uniform. So there will be most of the area bench slope parallelly vertical, that is inclined drilling is a more performance than the vertical drill and benching in the inclined nature. So here a less chance of the misfiring caused by the cutoff from the burden movement. Smoother and surrender slope from newly created benches means a better slope stability of benches. Higher productivity of front end loader and hydraulic excavators with the more swelling and relatively lower height of the mud pile. Less sub drill and better use of exposed energy. Within the consequent lower vibration levels, lower consumption of explosives per calm or rock excavation, and the shock wave is reflected more efficiently in the bench toy and possibility of increasing burden size with the less risk of toy appearance. In other words, top toy problems is greater resolved within the inclined drilling. Inclined drilling also no need of the toy formation, not possible. Most of them avoid it in an inclined manner of drilling. In surface a core may the mineral overbrushing is greatly reduced. These are the other criterias, major criterias for the advantage of inclined drillings, inclined drilling system. Now some more other patterns also is showing here. This is the phase, the delay element, zero is the delay element. One number is showing the sequence of pattern of drilling. There's a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, last. So first, what are the free phase? It is creating the easy to fragment. What's the spare pattern? This is also the staggered pattern. This is the phase. This is a number given 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, staggered pattern. But it's squared pattern. This is a square pattern, 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And these are the square pattern is concerned. The another is the face, and 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 5, 5, 3, 3, 7, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8. So this is the one more, another model. And this is also another model. So redraw this in our paper, it can be easily understand how are the holes are made and how do they are firing. This is also one important aspect. By seeing these are the equal nature, but by firing this is a different. So that's why the pattern of drill holes is one thing. Firing procedure is another. So to our aim to defragment in such a way and also falling the loser material in such a way should be in your hands, that is the blast designer hands. It can be possible to effectively that material can be defragmented at better. See this one a simple bench drilling, how the drill patterns are will be here. I am showing here. These are the production holes, these are the buffer holes, the pre-splitting. So once just like you have to maintain here also, it will be effective. So that's why any bench blasting, these are the patterns, blast holes are being made for the purpose of the first row for dividing is called as a pre-split holes. These are almost 4 or 1/4 inch, okay, which is there. It can be converted into meters also. This is 50 meters depth. Here 50 meter depth bench height. This is a further for progressing bench. But without affecting the slope stability of this bench, a pre-split is maintained by the simple dummy holes are prepared here. The rod blast. Then we separated the other section. These are the pre-splits. Another buffer holes. These are the buffer holes. They are not being filled with any explosive. These are buffer holes. So, now, blast holes. These are the explosive filled and blasted by the blast production holes, laser production holes. So this is the activities of blast hole patterns of drilling. Next, another sketch. This is a lot. Live image of the some iron ore mine. See the bench, same. What are the factors you studied in the earlier slide? That is the same thing. So see that these are the ores. So the drilling activity is going on here. So this is the way. This is the bench. You can see. So these are the. So one more figure is there here, similar. So very clearly, drills are progressing in a specific space. Building work is going on. So this is another pattern. How drill holes are made for the bench in a specific nature, distance, as per the design engineer given idea, accordingly. And then, so now I am coming to the process. Of above sketches concerned, above slides concerned. The drilling, the process of making holes by means of a hammering of the or rotary effect. Mechanism of drilling, this is the principle I am showing here. This is the principle. Primary, prime mover, the electrical or diesel are source of energy that will be. Rotating the drill rod, this is the main drill bit, this is the drill rod, this is the coupling, the prime motor is there. Transmission of energy from the rod to the application of the energy. So this is the major activities, mechanism of drilling is going on. So this is the energy going with the prime motor to the coupler to the drill rod will be active and drill bit will be penetrated to the underneath. Then, major type of drills are for making of the such holes. You can percussive or rotary drill can use, or the percussive top hammer drill also there. jack hammer and wagon drills also there. Drill bits and roller bits, drag bits, button bits also there. And on the blasting, there are two types of variables in the blasting design. One is the uncontrollable variable, which is already over there. Neighbor slides, geology and rock correction, local specification. And also a control below within our hands, that are the button and the spacing, the hole diameter, hole depth, the number of holes in the blast. Subgrade drill, stemming distance, stemming material also is very important. Powder factor is also another important. Now, blasting parameters, the button, the shortest distance between the two holes perpendicular to the face should be the adequate. Practically, the button is a 1/4 to 1/3 to bench height. This is the relation between the button and the height of the bench. That is the 2/1 of the bench height. This is the relationship between the button and height of the bench. Spacing, distance between the two consecutive holes in the row parallel to the face. It should be adequate in a practice. Spacing is equal to 1.0 to 1.5 of the button. Blasting parameters, stemming distance 0.72, 1.0 of button is adequate. Too much could lead to the excessive vibrations and poor fragmentation. So subgrade drill is more my blast holes may be not break to full length, especially when the blasting takes place in dense rock. In practice, subgrade drill is equal to 0.2 to 0.5 of button. Blasting parameters, bench height, for determining the bench height, stiffness ratio should be also followed. Stiffness ratio is equal to bench height to button must be between the 2.5 to 4. Decking, the technique of decking is to divide the explosive column into two or more charges using inert material. It confines explosive gases to ensure better energy distribution of the soft seal. Sometimes minimum deck thickness is equal to the. So, what is the minimum deck? You can understand bench height is there. For example, any area of height, bench height, some weak areas, it unnecessary you fill up with the high explosives, waste of the explosive, but means very low strength, low character, low poor nature in the rock hardness. In such a way, high explosive is the unnecessary using. In that place, simply put the deck, that is air or any wooden type material without filling the explosive. That is deck practices. Most of the cushion blasting also they are using same thing. And blasting parameter, powder factor is the amount of explosive in kg. Required to achieve 1 ton mineral. So this is the one of the simplest way of expression of powder factor. Powder factor is the amount of explosive kg required to achieve the 1 ton material. So amount of rock hole is equal to b into button into spacing into height. So that is, we'll get the volume of the particular one hole, how much volume will be produced. So divided by the explosive, then get the powder factor. So explosive consumption, the amount of explosive required to break the rock into the an average size is called the blasting consumption. Explosive consumption on a rock strength and a geology, a kind of explosive, size of the hole, delay system, incision system, product size, available free face, etc. These are the blasting parameters, intrinsic parameters for a purpose. Energy factors are the energy factors. Energy factors describe the energy distribution within the given unit of rock. Proper energy distribution is important in obtaining desired fragmentation, also to be avoid toy formation. Blasting parameters followed in open cast. There are two type of blasting parameters followed in open cast mine. Single row blasting pattern, multi-row blasting pattern. General multi-row blasting patterns are followed for better fragmentation and less explosive consumption. So these are the important to see that whether the which pattern will be fitted for the particular location. So optimum blast design, how we will get it arrived? So it is one simple empirical formula I have given here. In a holistic approach of the identifying and measuring costs involved in the different process, to maximize the overall profit, the concept developed by the Magnanian described the total blasting cost equal to CTC equal to, that is a total blasting cost per ton of the finished product, is a depending upon the CD, cost of drilling, cost of blasting, cost of hauling, cost of crushing, cost of loading, that is the CIL is also there, and also the total tonnage of the divided by the production will get the CT value. The CT value is the total blasting cost. How will it? Cost of drilling, cost of blasting, cost of hauling, crushing, cost of loading divided by the total tonnage of production will get the factor. This is a very one of the important empirical formula for calculation purpose, for the purpose of calculation of the activities. So this is I showing here one of the a typical example of blasting activity. So what are the various parameters? So once near a vertical displaced to the high confinement, so this is falling like this, sub-drill damage. Sub-drill will be damaged, not there sub-drill here. Pre-existing rock structure. A desert vertical final bench. Buffer rows, production rows. Then, this is the overall design parameters. Bench height, sub-drill patterns. Then, so these are the, so now the finalizing coming to the conclusion. So overall, in these lectures, the particularly what you are learned that basic two, which parameters in our hand, which are not, geology, formation of this inside rock formations or hardness, these are not our hands. Our hands is in drills, which type drill you are maintaining, what are the geometrical patterns of drill, there is a depth, diameter, spacing, of course button, these are spacing button is depending upon our usage of explosives. Not only that one, there also firing procedure, which patterns you are firing, also the another influencing of the factor for the getting the very effective utilization of the explosive with the reducing of the cost. In earlier classes, you are having given here slide one slide. This is the formula. So, how much cost will be incurred per ton? So, indirectly, it's a drilling depend, blasting, hauling, crushing. So, these are the right. So, when you reduce the drilling cost, automatically the factor will be rising. So when they're reducing the blasting cost, we are automatically reducing the overall cost. So see that the blasting, drilling, and these are the very important answers. Hauling is another factor. Crushing and loading, these are the another three factors which is not in our scope. But these two are in our hand, present chapter is concerned. So what way you are reducing, what way you are using also, one important thing for the blasting is concerned. Now summarizing all the today lecture, today we discussed about the surface mining, classify the drill holes, basic content, diameter, and pattern. then. So one quiz is important for the appearing of the complete examination purpose or user purpose. No precast mine, large diameter holes are above 200 to 250 mm. Above 150 to 250 mm. Above 100 to 250 mm or 50 to 200 mm. So most of the large diameters are mostly we're using the around above the 150 to 250 mm. We are using in the open cast is concerned. So write the some assignment is also there. Better to write about the drill holes and basing on depth, diameter, and patterns. So frequently questions also same thing. So I hope that you can all are able to understand the classification of drill holes basing on depth and diameter and pattern and different patterns and how they will be interrelated to one another. I wish thee all the best. Thank you.